Oscars, but no, they come in here and they spread their crisp packets all over the floor and their Coke cans and... Is that a fag end? There are ashtrays, you know. About time I got some gratification in this place. Just some gratitude, that's all I want. Yes. I need an Oscar, that's what I need. I shall see to it that I will get the Oscar for lifetime achievement. Yeah, that's what I need, an Oscar. Throw me a mantelpiece, hang on. Out to the football game. Tiny little bit, what's wrong with living room?
Ladies and gentlemen, can you hear me now? Thank you very much. And after that, wasn't really planned that delay, but we'll get on with the proceedings now. And may I just be the first to welcome you to the first annual Fulford Oscars in association with Bob's Organs of Ghoul. Yes, the stars are gathered, the tension is high, and now it's time to reveal who has won one of tonight's prestigious awards and who will come away. A loser. The time for talking is over. The time for telling is now. And would you please welcome the man to tell you just that, everybody's favourite television celebrity, Mike Spangles.
In association with Bob's Organs of Ghoul. Oscars 97. A couple of days ago, in the US of A, they had a similar gathering to this, and they've got copyright in Oscars 96, so we called it Oscars 97, I suppose, not to get involved in any legal entanglements, because those lawyers can be ruthless. I remember when I divorced my first wife. They were absolutely ruthless. They bled me dry, left me without anything. I think without a pot to piss in fact. Oh, we've got to move on then. Joining me this evening is a young lady. The producers thought it would be a good idea for me to have a female co-host. And I agree, it is a good idea. I'm all for this women's lib thing. It's brilliant. Burning your brows, excellent. So joining me this evening is a pretty lady. You look at her and listen to me. Her husband's giving her the night off from making his tea so she can be with us. So will you please put your hands together for Miss Tiffany Wellbright. I shouldn't say hostess, as that's a whore. Yes. just out of interest, though, how much? Am I going to ask something? No, not just for a laugh. Now, my researchers tell me that you've just recently been to Iceland.
That's right, I returned yesterday.
Now, I believe there's a good deal on fish fingers, 2 for £3.19.
No. I'm actually a researcher for the BBC and I returned from Iceland yesterday.
Nice. Well, let's get on with the ceremony anyway, yeah? And let's hope that it isn't interrupted by the evil phantom.
The phantom, Michael? What's this?
Well, there's an evil phantom that's rumoured to haunt this very hall. And cause catastrophe catastrophe aplenty in many productions, but I'm sure it won't trouble us tonight. And don't worry, I'll protect you.
Right, well, we all know why we're here tonight. We're here to reward those who achieved the greatest achievements in our film industry. So without much further ado, let's get on with the first award, which is the Best Actor.
Here to present the award is everyone's favourite Cockney, Michael Caine. Hello, Michael. Now, not lots of people know this, but you haven't actually won an Oscar yourself, have you?
No.
In fact, you haven't actually made many good films, have you? I mean, since the Italian job, it's all been pretty poor. What was that one with the Eskimos you were in?
On Deadly Ground.
That's it. Now, that was crap.
Well, so the nominations, please, Michael. Nominations for Best Actor are Ryan Giggs for Caught on the Movie.
Corn is a healthy and nutritious alternative to meat. I love it. I often have some kids around at my house to have some corn because it's healthy and nutritious. All the kids think I'm well good at football. And after we've had some corn, I take them into the garden and beat them. At football. Corn is a healthy and nutritious alternative to meat.
Can't see that I'm in love with Deirdre for her personality. Oh, you poor Moroccan boy, in love with a Lancastrian woman. I'm going to top myself.
Ritchie. I'm in Leeds. I'm going to see if this lady can pass the
The dad's doorstep child.
Shed, come through.
Never see my washing line. My husband works down the mine. When he comes home, his clothes are dirty and grimy. But after one teaspoon of Daz Ultra, they are bright and white and smell.
Well, I must say they are mighty white. In fact, they're whiter than white. So, you don't want your white to be the piss. Use Daz Ultra.
Sabotage of this pathetic Oscars ceremony, I have got my magnificent 10,000 ton weight to drop upon the winner of one of the Oscars, which I can't quite remember. They shall pay by fair means or foul, they shall pay!
Present the award is top French fashion guru and presenter of Eurotrash, Jean-Paul Gaultier. Hello, Jean-Paul, or should I say, guten Tag?
Would you agree Eurotrash is nothing more than soft porn?
Oui.
Well, do you think it's fair using women, exploiting them as men's sexual desires?
No, I think you're getting the wrong idea, Ellen. What's that for?
Well, if that's the case, why do show naked as an artistic statement?
Well, three good reasons for that. First, I'm a bloke. Secondly, the idea is just sick. And thirdly, it's just not practical, is it? Now, jump all there. When are you going to stop dropping those bombs on the Pacific Islands?
I personally disagree with your tests. I don't think Jacques Chirac's actions are representative of the views of the people of France.
All French people are the same. I sit about all day, chomping on onions, going honky, honky, honky. Dropping bombs on the Pacific Islands.
Mike, that's being a bit racist.
No, that's a fact. That's what French people do.
Well, it's very narrow-minded.
The nominees are the Scooby-Doo gang for the mystery of the witch with no nose, the Scooby-Doo gang for the mystery of the hidden jewels, and the Scooby-Doo gang for the mystery of the strange man, and the winner is the Scooby-Doo gang for the mystery of the witch with no nose.
Can't expect the animators for drawing us these past few years, and most of all to our fans, for making us the best animated ghost-busting quintet.
I'm afraid Scooby-Doo has something to say to you all.
Scooby-Doo. Scooby. Scooby-Doo. Doo-doo. Doo.
I'm afraid to say the rumours are true.
Scooby, Scooby. Scooby-Doo. A doo-doo-doo. Scooby. Scooby-Doo.
For once in their lives, the tabloids have been correct, and I'm leaving the group.
Scooby. Scooby, Scooby. Doo-doo. Scooby. Shaggy, Scooby. Scooby. Scooby-Doo.
I love you all.
Next year will be the best animated Ghostbusting quartet. Thank you very much.
Yikes! Suspicious.
It's a big inflatable banana.
What can it mean?
Daphne, magnifying glass.
Yes, Velma.
Jeepers.
This looks like it could be the first clue on the trail of our next mystery.
To the mystery machine.
Our next award this evening is for Best Foreign Film. That's right, foreigners can make films too.
And tonight, to present the award is a man you may have seen in many top movies. He's won some of the highest accolades for his roles in films, and he's joining us here tonight. Will you please put your hands together for Bruce Chang?
Now, Bruce, tell me, did your dad own a takeaway?
No, my father did not own a takeaway. My father was a top nuclear scientist. No, beyond information, Mike. My father was a top neurosurgeon.
Do any of your family own a takeaway?
Listen, I'm getting very, very sick and tired of these, well, racist comments.
Bruce, do you find it hard living in our society with all these associations people make with your culture?
Look, I think you're getting a bit deep here. What I want to know, Bruce, is how quick can you cook a stir fry?
Well, I do not know myself. My chef usually makes it for me.
Bring on the wok! Now, I want you to cook me a stir fry in under 1 minute.
No.
Please.
I said no.
Hold on, don't be as false, what?
Listen, mate, do you want to kick in the head? Because I'm quite willing to dish it out.
Take off the wok!
We please have the nominations, Bruce.
Yes, definitely, I'm mad. It's well about time. Now, the nominations for Best Foreign Film. Now, let's just see if we can get this envelope open. Right, now. Let's see, the first nomination for Best Foreign Film is an alternative Eskimo film entitled Big Betty Does the North Pole.
Thank you.
on the second nomination tonight is a martial arts flick entitled Revenge of the Dragon Monster and starring Oasis's Liam Gallagher.
You won't slap, because I'll slap your good man, I'll slap your soul up. You'll go all the way back to China, alright?
Oh, Mr. Gallagher, you play the hard man with your Manchester ways. But we preach the way of our true Buddhist contemplation.
You won't do it.
So, Mr. Gallagher, with my ancient Chinese art of Kung Fu honed over many centuries, I will defeat you now.
Hey, how about I just give you a good old-fashioned Mancunian slap, man? Come on, man.
And the third nomination is an alternative French film entitled Le Jambon Bleu.
Je t'aime.
Tu ne comprends pas.
Je voudrais un sandwich avec le jambon bleu, s'il te plaît.
Oui, à la gare.
Oui, à la gare. C'est une substitution pour les amants. Oui, moi.
And the winner of tonight's award, Best Foreign Film, goes to Big Betty Does an Up Poll.
We have this feeling as we believe the recurring motif of naked female flesh literally transcends the literal to expose the true expressionist meaning of our film. Hey, great pair of tits.
Show our fans.
Yeah.
Okay. So, like, all you gotta do, like, it's
follow me, okay? You're gonna be okay. Right, okay, we'll start over here. Just cool, okay, cool. Just cool, I'm on cool. Think don't draw, okay? Hey, wanna dance?
Yes, please.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And welcome to the world famous Jack Rabbit Slim's Twist Tournament. What's your name?
Mrs. Leah Wallace.
Who's your fella?
Vincent Vega.
Right, take it away.
Okay.
Scream!
Right, this is really loud. There's lots of Trina fans all out to see their favourite stars, and I've got one of them here. At the moment, Richard Kemp. Richard, how are you?
Someone's nicking a rubber doll.
Oh, Richard, here's your state of distress. Well, if I can have just a couple of words with you. You were very good at that, but I mean...
Thank you.
How do you manage to juggle the demands of being a top performing artist while at the same time being a top IT teacher?
I didn't think I did, and I'm very pleased that you think so.
Well, I'm sure there's many admirers out there that you don't realise you have, but they are there. Now, Richard, I'd love to talk to you all night, but unfortunately, we've got to keep this thing going. So if we go back to the studio, could I? No, I couldn't. I've got another minute. So. More questions. So, just think of stuff. Okay. Well, how's your?
Can I ask you one?
Yeah.
Have we got a microphone that works?
No. Well, it's plugged into my trousers. So.
Oh, trouser microphone. Right. I see.
So, but you filled up a good bit of the time there. I have to think of another one. But how do computers? How do they work?
Electric.
Okay, thank you. And that's it. So, we go back to the Oscars. Thank you, Richard Kemp.
We're going to have an interval now. 20-minute break. Join us in 20 minutes. So, drink and be merry. Thank you.
Are you having a good time?
Oh, wonderful. What do you think of the dentist? I think they're very, very
talented. They should go far. Well,
I mean,
everyone really is very excited about this evening, so let's get on with it. Mike, have you got any tips for this hour?
No, I'm not going to tell you.
Please, Mike, you know.
Can't sense it. Norman, it's a secret. Oh, I'm not going to tell you.
Okay. Well, have a good time. Sorry, Bob. Yeah, it's sure. Okay.
The next award tonight is the best speech in the award ceremony. This is where the stars get a chance to tell us how much they all love us.
Yes. When I was young, I was personally touched by Michael Jackson, but I of the earth. It reads, there I saw a woman sitting on a scarlet beast that was covered with blasphemous names and had seven heads and ten horns. The seven heads obviously referring to the winning lottery numbers, of which there are six. Seven, including the bonus ball. It continues. The woman was dressed in purple and scarlet and was glittering with gold, precious stones and pearls. Interesting, this reference to precious stones, as Meg, spelt backwards, is Jem.
Mr. Hayton for award ceremony, Liam Mando Gallagher for the Brits, and Tom Hanks for the Oscars. And the winner is Tom Hanks!
Award. It's not that I'm special, just I'm more talented than everybody else. Sadly, this award cannot be credited just to my genius. Mainly yes, but not entirely. I'd like to thank my wife. If it wasn't for her, I'd have married somebody else. I'd like to thank all of you peasants who came to see my films, admired my genius. I love you all.
Tom, can you just hurry up? Where
am I? No! People want to hear us!
Thank you.
antique plunger. Daphne, magnifying glass.
I'm sorry, Mum, I don't have it on me.
Oh dear. Well, I'll have to do a close inspection myself.
What's that?
Looks like a caretaker's brush.
What are you kids doing here? This is a stage, it's the Oscars! Well, I was cleaning! Things have got to be clean!
Suspicious!
What do we do next, gang?
Hey, why don't we follow those wires?
Trying to think, Shaggy.
Harry, why don't we follow those wires?
Good idea, Daphne!
Present the award is a popular 60s pop combo, The Beatles!
Seven Brides for Seven Brothers.
Tonight we have a special treat for you. We have an improvisational dance group, Pants People! Ha ha! Okay, Pam's people, thank you. Many people have their own idea of the most important role in a film. Some say best actor, some best supporting actor, some say best director. But here now is the most prestigious award ever available to any Hollywood star. Some will try, most will fail.
So we ask for complete silence and for you to bow your heads while we announce the nominees for Best Supporting Brick.
Will it be number one, who is the brick used to help Mel Gibson onto his horse in Braveheart?
Because he's only wee! Or will it be B. Rick Alessi in the soon-to-be-released 4-hour film version of Neighbours? He may be handsome, but he's got no personality, sorry girls.
On the other hand, could it be the brick who is given his big break in the top film, The Wizard of Oz, on the third row, 13th from the left, as one of the yellow bricks?
Of course, playing a very important role. Or will it be nominee number four, starred just off-screen in the fight between Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader in Star Wars?
It's a little-known fact that he was originally cast as the ghost of Luke's father, but he was told he was overqualified, allegedly. And the winner is the third brick, 13th from the left, in The Wizard of Oz.
Are there any plans for a sequel? Really? Yeah. Yeah. Right. Well, unless you're not actually yellow, do you spend a lot of time in makeup? How long exactly? That long. Yeah. Tricky part down front. Yeah. Well, the brick, ladies and gentlemen. Michael Barrymore. CD affair is just disgusting.
Right.
Okay, Mike, can we have nominations, please?
Certainly can. Nominations for best adaptation. The first one is called Dead Rabbits Don't Talk. It's a Quentin Tarantino adaptation of original Beatrix Potter.
Strike down, furious anger, those who attempt poison
and destroy my carrots.
Boy carrots!
And you'll know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee.
It's entitled A Testing Time for Donald, and this is a Walt Disney adaptation of George Orwell's classic, 1984.
So, Donald, refuse to talk. Well, you will talk. You will learn to talk, new speak. You will learn to think, new speak.
And the winner of Best Adaptation goes to Dead Rabbits Don't Talk.
Two tricks isn't very good, and they forgot one of my big speeches. But never mind, now comes the testing time. The time for the Lifetime Achievement Award, when the little people who have been trodden down in this world shall be recognized.
Here to present the award is someone who's achieved a great deal himself, Bob Geldof.
Come here tonight to present the Lifetime Achievement Award to someone who, over the last 20 years, has made the most outstanding contribution to the world of organs. His name is synonymous with organs all over the world. In fact, he's even touched the Archbishop of Canterbury's organ. And he's got the largest organ this side of Harrogate. Can you please give a big hand for Bob from Bob's Organs?
For the Rolf Harris stylophone.
business sort of just expanded like that, and now I've got the biggest organ inside America, don't you?
In a unit that's Gould's answer to the David Gate Arcade, I believe.
Absolutely.
Were all your family as common as you?
Yes. we come from a long line of organs. In fact, if you put us all together, we'd stretch right across the Pennines.
Indeed, eh?
Yes, I will, Mike.
Oh.